How is your fixed income fund different from other traditional and alternative products?
Well, the Southeaster has strived to be a multi-strategy fixed interest fund. So we never really focused on one specific area. We're active in five distinct areas. So depending on the opportunity set and whether one has trades that make sense and you can do, you tend to move around. So those areas, very simply put, directional trades where one looks at the actual direction of the market. Are yields going to rise in a bearish scenario or fall? Then credit type strategies. So if you look at a corporate bond, if you're positive about the corporate and you think that there's a possibility of a rating upgrade, then you would buy the corporate bond. You'd hedge out the interest rate risk by shorting a government bond against it, and then you'd hold it for your holding period and wait for the good news that you're expecting to transpire. Alternatively, if you're very bearish of a corporate or a parastatal, you can short sell the bond. Again, hedge it by buying a government bond against it, and then you wait for either a rating downgrade to occur or the earnings to fail and the share price to fall and ultimately the bond price to fall. Then switch or yield curve type trades, those we're very active in. I would say 30 to 50% of the leverage of the fund gets used in those type trades. There, typically, one takes a view on the shape of the yield curve, and that's very often determined by the Reserve Bank. So, in a rate cutting environment, where the short end of the curve is being reduced by the Reserve Bank cutting rates. You'd put on a bond steepener, so you'd buy a short-dated bond and you'd sell a long-dated bond, so you get a yield curve shape change. Alternatively, in a rate hiking cycle, you would tend to buy long-dated bonds and short the short-dated bonds, and one does this in an interest rate neutral fashion so that you're not exposed to whether interest rates are rising or falling per se, but again, just focusing on that shape change in the yield curve. It's also influenced, the yield curve is also influenced by inflation. So we focus very closely on inflation. We have an inflation model and we forecast inflation, which is difficult, but from time to time we get lucky, we're able to call it. And having a view on inflation informs what the Reserve Bank will do given the inflation targeting mandate. So that's a very important skill to develop and cultivate. And then inflation-linked trades. So there we look at inflation-linked bonds. Similar to nominal bonds, we can trade directional trades, yield curve trades, or credit trades in inflation-linked bonds. But it's a much trickier market. It's a lot more illiquid, so it can be quite difficult to operate in. And then the final area where we operate is relative value. So looking at swaps versus bonds or short-dated arbitrage opportunities between, say, money market rates and short-dated bonds. So those are the five areas that the Southeaster Fund operates in. Generally, our fund is a risk-managed fund, so we aim to focus on risk management, so monitoring things like the value at risk that I mentioned, making sure that we maintain our leverage below our leverage limit. And I've always believed in you get the risk management right and then the returns will follow afterwards. So only once you've achieved your risk management, then can you look for your returns afterwards. The other key focus of the fund is to have a diversified source of returns. So those five areas that I mentioned that we operate in, to make sure that no one particular trade dominates. So if you get it wrong in that particular strategy, or if something unforeseen happens and you have one massive bet in one strategy, you can have very volatile returns. So try and have a basket of diversified trades. You might not deliver as high returns in the short term, but in the long term, you limit your downside risk and you tend to smooth your return profile. And then the return target of the fund is to deliver JIBAR plus 5% over 1, 2, 3 years. It's more a long-term target, and we aim to achieve that target gradually rather than aggressively chasing it from month to month.
Thank you, Alistair, for sharing more detail on the firm, the fund, and how you got into the industry.
My pleasure. Much appreciated.
And thank you for tuning into Black Onyx. For more details on the alternatives, please visit our website.